Namaste students. Now in the last session we were discussing about matrix minima method, and I have completed one problem under matrix minima method. So today we shall see two more problems under particular method. Now you are seeing the problem over there. Now see there, a steel plant. See the problem. Solve the following transportation by matrix minima method and also obtain the transportation cost. Here, steel plant and company is given. Three steel plants are there, A, B, C, and their three companies are given. Now we have to start with the least cost. As I said, here among the cost, see this 1 to 3. It is a company name. First company, second company, and third company. Don't get confused. And these are the availability and requirement. These numbers. So only these three, 4, 2, 5, 2, 5, 1, 3, 6, 5. These are the cost. Among this, which is the least one? One is the least one. In previous problem, when we observed, there 2, 1 was there. One was here, and one was here. So in such case, where we can find two least cost, we can go better to go with the first one. So here we don't have such kind of problem. Only one least cost is there. If we compare all these costs. So we should go with this particular value. So this is the least cost. Now solution. Start with the least cost cell. Which is the least cost cell? Least cost cell is 2, C. Least cost cell is 2, C. Now allocate x to c is equal to minimum. See there, which is minimum? First we have to take available, that is 20, and here it is 30. 20, 30. Minimum we get there 20. So what we need to allocate here? We need to allocate 20. We need to allocate here 20, and this availability gets over. So what will remain in case of requirement? 20 we allocated here, 10 will remain. Now you see among the remaining cost, how many? 4, 2, 5, 3, 6, 5. Which is the least one? Least one is 2 here. This already got over. Here remaining in the next least is this one, 2, which is the cell. That is 1, B. So second allocation is in the cell. Second allocation is in the cell. What is that cell? That is 1, B. 1, B. Now allocate x 1b is equal to minimum. Now see, what is the minimum value over there? Here, what is the availability? Is 50, and here requirement is 22. So 50, 22. Which is minimum? This minimum is 50. So we need to allocate here 50. Here we need to allocate 50. Now this particular availability got over. When we allocate 50 here, what will remain? 22 minus 50. What will remain? 7 will remain over here. Now you see remaining cost 3, 6, 5. Which is the least one? Least one is 3. So which is that cell? 3, 8. Now third allocation is in the cell. Which is that cell? That is 3, 8. Now allocate x3a is equal to minimum. What is minimum there? See there, availability is 25 and requirement is 8. 25, 8, which is the minimum, 8 is the minimum there. So we have to allocate here 8. We have to allocate 8, and this particular requirement takes over. What will remain? We allocated 8 here. 25 minus 8, there 17 will remain. Now next allocation. Here two values are remaining, 6 and 5. Which is the least? 5 is the least. Which is that cell? 3, C. So fourth allocation is in the cell. Which is that cell? 3, C. That is 3, C. So allocate X3C is equal to minimum 17 and 10 here. 17, 10, which is the minimum. 10 is the minimum. So we need to allocate here 10. Here we allocate 10. And when we allocate 10 to this particular requirement gets over, out of 17 we allocated 10. What is remaining? Then 7 will remain. 7 will remain. And which is the last cost? That is 6 is remaining one. This is the last allocation we have to do here, which is that cell 3, B. And here also 7. Here also 7 is remaining. So last allocation is in the cell. What is that cell? That is 3, B, B, B. So allocate X, 3B, minimum, what is remaining? 7 and 7. 7, 7 is equal to 7. We have to allocate 7. We have to allocate 7. So both availability and requirement gets over. So this kind of problem we can call it as, it's a balanced problem, since we have got equal values and for the last allocation. Now write the allocations. What and all we allocate is. What is that first allocation? First allocation is in X23 we allocated 20. Then next allocation, that is X1B, what do we allocate? 15. We allocated 15 there. Next allocation, that is 3X3A, we allocated 8. Next allocation, that is X3C, what do we allocate? That is 10. And last allocation is in the cell X3B. Then we allocated 7. Total how many allocations we have done? We have done here 5 allocations. Now what we need to find out? Obtain the transportation cost. We have to find out the transportation cost. Prepare the table now. Now, firstly we write the availability and requirement, that is 15, 20, 25, then requirement 8, 22, 30. Now we write the allocation. First, in the first row, allocation is 2 and here it is 2, cost is 2. cell, that is 1, and we allocated 20. Then in the third row, cost is 3, we allocated 8 there. The cost is 6, we allocated 7, and here cost is 5, we allocated 10. Now we have to check whether it is initial basic feasible solution. How we can say now here 15, yes, it is equal to 15. It can match 20. Yes, here see the allocation 8 plus 7 plus 10, total 25 we get. Okay, that satisfies the availability. Then we see requirement 8, 7 plus 15, 22, 10 plus 20, 30. So it satisfies availability as well as requirement. So we can call the given solution is basic feasible solution. Now we will find out the transportation cost. Transportation, that is sigma Cij into Xij. Now here, that is 3 into, start from 2 into 15 plus 1 into 20 plus 3 into 8 plus 6 into 7 plus 5 into 10. Now here 2 into 15, that is 30, here it is 20. Now 24 plus 6 into 7, that is 42 plus 50. So what do we get? We get a 166, which is the transportation cost. We found out transportation cost there. Now we have to conclude there whether it is, yes, we know that it is initial basic feasible solution, and m plus n minus 1, what do we get? Now we'll see m plus n minus 1. How many origins? 3. How many destinations? 3. Minus 1. We get there 15. What is the allocation? How many allocations? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is equal. If it is equal means, then it is problem is of non-degenerate. So we have to conclude now. The given transportation problem is a basic feasible solution, and it has non-degenerate solution. Since number of non-zero allocations are equal to m plus n minus 1, that is 5. Number of non-zero allocations are equal to m plus n minus 1. So this is about, here we worked out now two problems under least cost method. Now we will see one more problem under least cost method. Now we will see one more problem under least cost method. Solve the following transportation by matrix minima. Matrix minima or least cost. Okay. And also obtain the transportation cost. Now see the problem. That x, y, z, that is different destinations. From where we need to transfer the goods, A, B, C, that we can take as plant or any company which produces some of the articles. Okay, now availability you see 60, 70, 80, and requirement is 50, 80, 80, and 210. Now we have to start with the least cost. Now, which is the least cost here? These are the requirement and these are the availability. Now, among this, which is the least cost? Least cost is 3, and 1, 3 is here, 1 more is here, 1 more is here. Now, we have least cost in a 3 different cells or location. Better to go with, as I said, it is better to go with first one, 3. Then we can see this one and this one. It doesn't make any mistakes, or it doesn't make any kind of difference to take this search, or else to take this search. You can go with any of the least value. So we will go with this one, Now, start from least cost cell. Least cost cell. What is that cell? Now concentrate properly. We are in the third one. That this is the cell. Which cell it is? A comma Z. That is A comma Z. Cell is A comma Z. Then allocate X, A, Z, their minimum. See now, this is the cell. What is the availability? 60. In this cell, what is the requirement? 80. 60, 80. In this, what is minimum? 60 is the minimum. So we have to get availability is minimum than the requirement. So we allocate this 60. First allocation is 60. Now we don't have anything to allocate further in this particular row, so we can cut it. Now we allocated 60. What is remaining here? 80 minus 60. Already 60 is allocated. Now 20 is remaining. Now we see in remaining cost which is the least. 3 is the least. 2 are there. We'll take the first one. Which cell is there? B comma X. Now second allocation is in the cell which cell it is? B comma X. That is B comma X. Now next allocate X. B, X is equal to minimum. What is the minimum value here? What is the availability? 70 for this cell and requirement is 50. So 70 comma 50, which is minimum here? 50. That we need to allocate here. We allocate 50 here. If we allocate 50, which gets over? The requirement gets over. So we can strike out. Now if we allocate 50, what will remain here? 20 will remain. Okay, next, which is the least among these four? Now these four are remaining. This is the least, so we'll go with this cell. That is cell is 3,1. Third allocation is in the cell. Third allocation is in the cell, that is C comma Y. Now allocate X C Y is equal to minimum. What is minimum there? Here, what is the availability is 80 and even requirement is also 80. 80 availability and 80 requirement. So here it will become your requirement is equal to availability. So we have to allocate here 80. What happens here? Both availability and this requirement gets over. Now what is the last cell is remaining? 9. This is remaining. Which is that cell? B comma Z. Last allocation is in the cell. Is in the cell, that is B comma Z. B comma Z. Allocate X B Z is equal to minimum. Now see there. In this column 20 and here also 20. 20 comma 20 is equal to 26. Now we allocate 20. Both availability and requirement gets over. Now allocation got over. How many allocations we have done? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 allocations. Now write here number of allocations. Now number of allocations which are the those. First one, x, a, z. What do we allocate? 60. Comma, x, bx, bx is equal to 50. Then next, x, y. What do we allocate over there? There it is, 80. The last allocation is in the cell XBZ is equal to 20. Total 4 allocations we have done. Now we need to find out their total transportation cost. Now draw the table again. That is XYZ and AYU. We can write as AI. And this side it is A, B, C, and requirement we write it as B, J. And this is from this source to this destination. Source to destination. Complete the table. Now write the allocations. That first allocation, see there in the first row, that cost was 3. What do we allocate it? There we allocated 60. In here it is, cost is 3 and we allocated there 50. Next cost is 9, we allocated there 20. Then cost is 3, here we allocated there 80. Is it 4 allocations or 5 allocations? 4 allocations. It is 80. These are the allocations. Now write the requirement and availability. That is 50, 80 and 80. Here it is 210. Then 60, 70, 80. 60, 70 and 80. Now check there whether it is basic feasible solution. Now here 60, yes, total is 10. 50 plus 20. Availability is 70. Okay, 80. Availability is 70. Now requirement 50. Here it is 80. 60 plus 20 is 8. Yes, it is basic feasible solution. And we can say this problem is balanced because last allocation we get as equal numbers. Last allocation, if we get equal numbers, we can say it's the problem is balanced. And if it satisfy the requirement and as well as availability means, we can say it is a basic feasible solution. Now, find out the transportation cost. Transportation cost is equal to sigma Cij into Xij. Now here, 3 into 60 plus 3 into 50 plus 9 into 20 plus 3 into 80. Now on 80 plus 150 plus 180 plus 240. So what will be the total? Total we get as 750. So this is the total transportation cost. I hope it is clear. Transportation cost 3 into 50 plus 9 into 20 plus 3 into 80. Sorry, 3 into 60 plus 3 into 50 plus 9 into 20 plus 3 into 80. That we have to total. That's it. Now check there whether it is degenerate or generate solution. Now m plus n minus 1. How many number of sources? 3. How many number of destinations? 3. Minus 1. That is, we get 5. How many number of allocations? Number of non-zero allocations are 4. But Here m plus n minus 1 is 5. So here number of allocations are less than m plus n minus 1. So solution is generate. So solution is degenerate. Otherwise, solution is non-degenerate. Now write the conclusion. Given transportation problem is a basic feasible solution and it has a degenerate solution since number of non-zero allocations, which is non-zero allocations, these are allocations are less than m plus n minus 1. What is that? That you get 5. So this is the conclusion. I hope you are clear about how to solve problem under matrix minima as well as matrix minima at northwest corner rule. So here with this we can conclude with the topic of matrix minima. Now in the next session I will solve the same problem under matrix minima as well as least cost. So you will get to know in which method we will get the transportation cost as least, whether it is northwest corner rule or least cost. Say this problem, again I am telling, it is not a difficult problem. It is easy. Both the methods are procedures, everything is similar. Just while allocating, in case of least, you have to see which is the least number. You have to take firstly, you have to start from the least number. Then in case of northwest corner rule, you have to take the corner value, which is the corner value. Then I am striking out for the purpose that you have to understand. For that purpose, I am striking out. Otherwise, we can take different tables also and we can do. That is a lengthy procedure. For that purpose, I am striking out here. Or here with this table also, you can see whether we get. For the purpose of practice, you can take only table and you can solve. Without writing all this purpose. Now, with this only we can solve. But when it comes for exam, you have to follow this procedure. You have to follow this procedure here at this point table and transportation cost. Then you have to give the conclusion. So, with this, we'll wind up with this session. The next week, we'll solve same problem under both the methods.